that we may be dealing with this year is because of the Supreme Court ruling on collection of sales tax outside of the state. There could be the opportunity for Tennessee to go ahead and take advantage of that so that there's a more level playing field between the brick and mortar here and folks who have businesses here in Market Square and there. I think the feeling among most people, since Republicans are in charge, will be that anything that we do will try to be tax neutral. That if we figure this out-of-state tax is going to bring in, you know, $300 billion, then we're going to find a way to reduce something else, $300 million, whether we reduce the sales tax or something like that. So that's what I'm hearing on that end. Education is always very important to me, and I like your stance on educational freedom. When I first ran in 94, 24, 25 years ago, I talked about that, and the more I look into it, it makes sense. It's what we do in higher education. We give the parents, whether through a Pell Grant or the Hope Grant, we say, here's the money, and you find the school, public or private, that fits your child's needs the most. And I think it's very hard to argue that putting the kid in a school based on their zip code is really focused on the student. It's more focused on how the school system can operate and do their bus routes or build classrooms like that. But it's really not centered on what is best for the students. I'll be very involved, like I've always been, on that issue. My concern where my mind is a lot is not so much on legislation that I'll be hearing. I know we'll have 15 bills, and I know by the end I'll have 15. I've got a list of possible things, and I'll have to wait until I see all the requests, and then I'll pick it out. But I'm more focused on that we have a new governor, a new Speaker of the House, new Chairman of Finance, Chairman of Education.
New Speaker Pro Tem?
Well, a new Speaker Pro Tem on Tuesday. I may be number two in the House, which I'm very well suited for because in my own house I'm number two. I've served with giants, with Ben Ashley, who we lost recently, Doug Henry, you know, both Republican and Democrat. I've seen people who are true statesmen who put the state first, and I want to make sure that we continue that in Tennessee. We are so much more fiscally responsible than other states, and it's just like in your own household. If you're fiscally responsible, if you're not deep in debt, if you've got some money in savings, it allows you a lot more choice and options when bad times come. I don't know how some of these states, like Kentucky, whose pension program is, what, 36%, yeah, something like that, funded. I don't know what they're going to do that. And so what I kind of see my role in being, and one reason I'm seeking to be Speaker Pro Tem, there's really not much of a job description. I mean, I don't know, you just wait around for the Speaker to become incapacitated. But it allowed me the freedom to see whether, you know, if a freshman, I'm going to really try to work with the freshman as much as I can, and wherever there's a problem, I think I can use my institutional knowledge to go and help people out. So that's really where my heart is and where my focus is. Obviously, having served 24 years, I've got more years behind me than in front of me, and I want to make sure that when it's my time to go, like Senator Ashley left, Doug Henry, and those, that there'll be people behind who will have that still strong, fiscally responsible, putting the state first. So that's what I'm going to work on.